Hey Zoo fans! In this video, we're going to go over how to set up and maintain ZooMed's Nano 10. The Nano 10 is an external canister filter that's designed to help maintain clean water in aquariums. This filter combines mechanical, chemical, and biological filtration to efficiently clean up to 10 gallons of water. Before starting, review the included instructions to make sure all of the parts of the filter are included. Once everything is accounted for, you can begin setting up the filter. Begin by mounting the screw nuts onto the filter head and attaching the suction cup clips to the suction cups. To apply the suction cups to the clips, simply press and twist. Now we will put together the filter's water intake unit. Find one of the two hard elbow units, attach the intake tube to the non-threaded pipe of the elbow, and screw the screw nut to the threaded pipe. The intake tube is the clear plastic tube that does not have the irrigation holes down the side. Next, snap the intake strainer closed and attach it to the opposite end of the intake tube. Lastly, add the suction cup clips to the intake tube. Next, we'll put together the outlet unit. Attach the second hard elbow unit to the small elbow piece and screw the screw nut to the threaded pipe. From here, you have the option of attaching the spray bar or the flow diverter. When attaching the spray bar, add the two suction cup clips and plug the opposite end of the tube. Once you've set up the intake and outlet units, you can begin assembling the filter. Start by attaching the four rubber feet to the bottom of the filter. To open the unit, press and hold the orange safety button and slide it to the right-hand side of the canister. Do this for each latch. When in the unlocked position and viewed from above, the latches will be on opposite sides. Now pull the head of the filter up. The filter head creates an airtight seal. Wiggle the filter head while pulling to loosen the seal. Once you have the unit open, remove the filter sponge. Rinse the sponge, carbon bag, and ceramic media under running water to remove any dust or debris. Place the filter sponge into one chamber with the hole facing upwards. Place the carbon bag in the bottom of the empty chamber. Take note that the carbon should not be removed from the bag. Add the ceramic media on top of the carbon bag. Lastly, make sure the intake strainer is attached correctly on the impeller cover and that the air vent tube in the filter head is pointed upwards. Fit the filter head back onto the unit, making sure the fill cap is over the chamber with the ceramic media. Secure the latches on the sides of the canister, and your filter should now be ready to install. For installation, situate the intake and outlet units the way you want them in your tank. Secure the suction cups to a clean, smooth surface. The intake strainer should be completely submerged in water. Positioning the spray bar just above the water's surface will create surface agitation and increase oxygenation. Place the canister on a flat surface near the tank and attach the two clear rubber hoses. The intake hose should be connected to the in-pipe on the canister, while the outlet hose should be connected to the opposite, unmarked pipe. Once the hoses are in place, tighten down the screw nuts on the end of each hose. Make sure there are no kinks in the hose. Hoses can also be cut shorter if needed. Now that the filter is ready, remove the fill cap on the top of the filter and fill the canister with dechlorinated water until it's almost overflowing. Replace the cap and make sure it's secure. Now, plug the filter in and it should instantly turn on. For safety reasons, it's recommended to have a drip loop. Do this by letting part of the filter's cord hang below the power outlet. Your filter is now ready and operational. This filter should be cleaned at least once per month. For maintenance purposes, always disconnect any electrical appliances used with or around the tank. Loosen the screw nuts and disconnect the hoses from the intake and outlet units to avoid siphoning. For regular cleaning, take the filter head off and remove the sponge and carbon. Clean the sponge under running water to remove as much debris as possible. Rinse the ceramic media in dechlorinated water and replace the carbon bag every 3 to 4 weeks. From time to time, you'll want to remove and clean the filter strainer and impeller cover. To access the impeller, gently pull the impeller housing off and pull up on the impeller. Clean both the impeller and the impeller chamber. Once finished, return all the parts to their appropriate positions and make sure each one is fastened correctly. If they aren't appropriately fastened, the filter may not operate. Lastly, make sure the air vent tube is pointing upwards. Lock the filter head back onto the canister and attach the hoses to the intake and outlet units. Be sure that the intake tube is attached to the side that says in. Fill the canister with water through the fill cap until it's almost overflowing and replace the cap. Plug the filter in and your filter should now function like new. That's all for now. See you next time.